How much? How much? 15. How much in the casinos?
35 and 40.
Oh, they're ripping us off, aren't they?
Yes, they are.
The Oyo Hotel is the newest brand to grace the Las Vegas Strip, but if you weren't familiar, that's okay. They are the third largest hotel operator in the world by number of rooms and properties, but they're based predominantly over in Asia. Now, if you're not familiar with Oyo, you might recognize the name Hooters. You may also know San Remo. That's because this property was formerly both Hooters and the San Remo. And if you blinked last month, you would have missed it. Where one day when everybody woke up, the hotel was magically transformed from the Hooters to the Oyo. But are they doing all the right things? That's yet to be seen. They say there's a renovation coming, but travel websites don't seem to give very good reviews of the rooms, saying that they're nothing like the pictures, so maybe they're phasing it in. Let's take a walk and check out the Oyo Hotel, all right? So what's going on out there, everybody? I'm gonna take a quiet moment to introduce myself and tell you that I am Steven and I am not leaving Las Vegas. I'm taking a little bit of a back way to the main strip right now, but we're gonna talk about the Oyo, as we said in the introduction to this video. And if you really don't know what it is, that's okay too. But the question of the day is this, what is the worst budget hotel and the best budget hotel you've ever stayed in Las Vegas? Or do you say, oh, I don't do budget hotels and motels. I only go for the Bellagio. Sound off in the comments below. If you guys want to support the channel, you're going to go ahead, like, share, subscribe this video. And if you're coming to Vegas, make sure you hit the links. You can save big on Vegas.com. You could buy something from my Teespring store. And you can help me explore a little bit more, just like this alleyway right here. So in order to get to the Oyo, it's quite simple. You just go south on the strip until you hit up Tropicana, and then you go about maybe half a block, just the length of the Tropicana Hotel itself, eastbound. And you're going to be right across the street from the MGM Grand, which we can see behind me right there. So I got to boogie woogie and get down there. Whoa, did I just say boogie woogie? Thumbs up for the weird old terminology I inherited from my parents. Let's go explore the strip while we walk a little bit. Get down to the Oyo and take a tour through this hotel. And I just thought of something. I sure hope they allow cameras down there, because if they don't, it's going to be another adventure here in Vegas. So as I say with the sun squinting in my eyes, we have a mantra out here in Las Vegas, and that is, if it's flat, build something, will ya? So right now we have a few things. This, how much? How much? 15, how much in the casinos?
35 and
40. Oh, they're ripping us off, aren't they?
Yes, they are. So it's fight night here, so I just realized it's gonna be slammed with people here to watch. I believe it's Canelo Alvarez fight. I don't know much about the fight, but we're walking past where they're building up the Target store. Oh, there's a game you should never play. So they're building up a Target here. And if you want to find the Red Queen before Target opens, you could definitely do that. I better leave, because those guys right there, they don't want to be seen on camera for obvious reasons. Let's continue on before we get ourselves in big trouble. but I can't really give you the feel for how Vegas has become a festival town unless I show you how loud it is right here by the New York, New York. On game day for the Vegas Golden Knights, and practically any other day they feel like it, they have live entertainment right in front of the New York, New York, just to draw you in. We're only one half a block away from the Oyo, so let's complete our walk in, check out the hotel, and see if it's worth your while and time to check it out yourself while you're here. So right now I'm almost at the Tropicana, and the Oyo is just right there. And my wife and I had one of our very first dates at the Tropicana. It was an old place called the Comedy Stop at the Trop. It doesn't exist anymore. Now we have the Laugh Factory, where they're manufacturing laughs one joke at a time. But let's head over to Oyo. It's about time we get in those front doors, isn't it? Jeez, this video is so long already. It's almost like us YouTubers do this on purpose. Wink, wink. So the good news is we finally made it to Trop. Whoa! You're messing up my video! The good news is we finally made it to Tropicana. And somebody needs to tell me, what is going on with David Copperfield? Is he making flying saucers and dinosaurs appear now? I guess that show's been retooled. He's a time traveler from the planet Copperfield. Look, there's the Oyo. I better stop talking now. So according to the sign, there's still a Hooters in here. So I guess that is the old saying, you can take the Hooters out of Las Vegas, but you can't take the Las Vegas Hooters out of the Oyo. I don't think that's a saying. Either way, I don't know how camera friendly they are in here, as I mentioned. Just to give you a couple of side notes on this casino, this has 30,000 square feet of casino floor space. It was purchased for a paltry, I think it's $128 million just this last year. You can see the temporary tarps up on the top right there. So it's obvious that whatever they're doing, it's going to be more better in the future. So let's go check it out, see what it's like. Is it worth your while? We're about to find out, and the suspense is killing me. Good. No one's come up to me and asked me to, sir, please put down the camera. This place is actually a lot nicer than I ever remembered it being as a Hooters. We have a Steak and Shake over here. You have a couple of shows going on at this place as well. And the casino floor is cozy, not too crowded right now, which might not bode well for them as a casino company, but they're partnered up with somebody else anyways on the casino management side. Let's take a quick swing through here and see what's up. This is the most lit up neon casino floor I've ever walked through. This is pretty incredible. I mean, you have every single machine, like every machine is brand new and absolutely massive. Usually casinos have a mix of old machines and new machines. They have a couple of the old Game King type, I think they're called here as well. I'm not a gamer, but I will tell you, it's so neat to see so many new machines in one place all at once. So it's real loud. I'm in front of this place called The Porch right now. It's a Ben and Jerry's place here, and I also have the pool and fitness center. Now, I guess it's open, you know? Heaven knows there's a cross guard. There's a lifeguard on duty. And look at that, they have movie nights at the pool here. Oh, am I the only one that noticed the old flamingo motif? if that doesn't scream late 60s, early 70s, if not 50s. But this building has been here since the 70s, so it's not that quite that old. And that's really what we got to take a look at here. I'm going to head back out, give you a shot going out, and you guys can let me know what you think of the Hoya Hotel and Casino in the comments below. They haven't kicked me out yet. Look, it's the Hooters Saloon. And yes, it is a branded Hooters place. And yes, you can market themselves for free. All we gotta do is touch to take a picture. So if I want to give all my information to them, I can log in with Facebook. But I ain't no fool, so I think I'll just make sure that I keep the camera footage on that one. So I stopped the video right now to say no small scale casino in Vegas, even large ones, would be without a timeshare booth. Timeshare booths pay a lot of money and they lend a lot to the bottom line operating dollar. So we see the exit right here. We have a nice modern take on a much older building here in Las Vegas. Interested to hear your thoughts below, and we'll sum it up with my thoughts in just a minute. According to the sign, we are now leaving. Oh, I thought it said leaving. We're living the good life over at the Hoya. But I'm interested in what you think after what you just saw. Does this look like the kind of small scale casino that you might like? And is Hoya really making all of the right choices for entering into this hyper competitive marketplace? According to different reviews I could find for the rooms that are pretty much modern on sites like Hotels Tonight and TripAdvisor, this place doesn't look too hot when it comes to actually booking a room. You might be having a crapshoot for how you actually get to stay here. So if they are doing a remodel or a renovation, a few rooms at a time or a couple hundred at a time, granted there's only I think like 650 rooms here, you might stay in a good room, you might not. But this is one of those hotels in Vegas that oftentimes gets overlooked. Its proximity to the David Copperfield Space Alien and Dinosaur Show at the MGM Grand is good for some people. Its closeness to the T-Mobile Arena is good for others. And maybe it's just a good place for you to go play where you can have some lower limits, some cheaper drinks, and a good time. And that's really what Vegas is all about. It's about having a good time. It's about being yourself and expressing yourself. Sometimes ourselves are the MGM Grand. Sometimes ourselves are to dress up to the nines and look fantastic and stay at the Bellagio. But other times, you just want to wear your old shoes, get off work, go somewhere fun, and connect with people. So maybe the Hoya is that, because I know that's what they're aiming for with the Hooters and the San Remo before it. So once again, I'm Steven. I'm not leaving Las Vegas. Please like, share, subscribe if you got this far. Tell somebody about this video who might appreciate it. And tell me what your favorite low budget or worst hated low budget casino and hotel is in Vegas. Until next time, let's walk the strip.